You know that saying, keep your friends close, but keep your enemies closer? That advice needs to go right out the window when we're talking about black holes. They're the worst enemies you could have, and you want them as far away as possible. We're talking regions of space where matter is compressed so densely that the only way to escape is to be traveling faster than the speed of light. And as we know, you can't go faster than the speed of light, so there's no escape. Get too close to a black hole and you'll be compressed beyond comprehension, perhaps into an infinitely small point. But you can be reasonably distant from a black hole too, and it'll still have your day ruined. A black hole reaches out through the light years with its gravity, and if one were to wander too close to our solar system, it would wreak havoc on all our precious planets. The planets and even the sun would be gobbled up or smashed together or even just thrown out of the solar system entirely. As we learned in a previous episode, black holes are unkillable. Anything you might try to do to kill them just makes them bigger, stronger, and angrier. Your only hope is to just wait them out over the eons it takes for them to evaporate. So it makes sense to keep track of all the black holes out there just in case we might need to evacuate this solar system in a hurry. So where are the closest black holes? So there's two kinds of black holes out there, the supermassive black holes at the heart of every galaxy, and the stellar mass black holes formed when massive stars die in a supernova. The supermassive ones are relatively straightforward. There's one at the heart of pretty much every single galaxy in the universe. One in the middle of the Milky Way, located about 27,000 light years away. One in Andromeda, 2.5 million light years away, and so on. No problem. The supermassive ones are really, really far away, no threat to us. The stellar mass ones might be more of a problem. So here's the problem. Black holes don't emit any radiation. They're completely invisible. So there's no easy way to see them in the sky. The only way you'd know there's a black hole is if you were close enough to see the background starlight getting distorted. And if you're close enough to see that, you're already dead. The closest black hole we know of is V616 Monoceratus, also known as V616 Mon. It's located about 3,000 light years away and has between 9 and 13 times the mass of the Sun. And we know what's there because it's located in a binary system with a star about half the mass of the Sun. Only a black hole could make its binary partner buzz around so quickly. Astronomers can't see the black hole, but they know it's there by the whirling gravity dance. The next closest black hole is the classic Cygnus X1, which is about 6,000 light years away. It has about 15 times the mass of the Sun, and once again, it's in a binary system. The third closest black hole is also in a binary system. See the problem here? The reality is that a fraction of black holes are actually in binary systems, but that's our only way to detect them. More likely, there are more black holes, much more close than the ones astronomers have been able to discover. So this all sounds terrifying. I'm sure you're now probably got one eye on the sky watching for that telltale distortion of light for an approaching black hole. But these events are impossibly rare. The solar system has been around for more than 4.5 billion years, with all the planets going around and around without interruption. So even if a black hole passed the solar system within a few dozen light years, it would have messed up the orbit significantly and life probably wouldn't be here to consider this fact. We didn't encounter a black hole in billions of years and probably won't encounter one for billions or trillions more. So sadly, the answer to the question is, we don't know. We just don't know if the closest black hole is a few light years away or it's actually V616 Mon. We'll probably never know. But that's fine. They're so rare, it's not worth worrying about. So keep those black hole questions coming. We're happy to keep doing shows about your questions about these crazy astronomical events. In our next episode, we talk about our little corner of the universe. Is there something special and different from the rest of the universe? Oh, and make sure you stick around for the blooper. Speaking of bloopers, our Patreon community sees entire blooper reels, gets advanced access to all our videos, and sees no ads on Universe Today. Join the club of 499 amazing people who support us in making great space and astronomy content. The people who make these shows even possible. We'd like to thank David Carsley, David Trog, and Matt Woods, and the rest of the members who support us in making great space and astronomy content. The members get advanced access to episodes, extras, contests, and other shenanigans with me and the rest of the team. Do you want to get on the action? Click here.
Might have to do that again, you stumbled.
I know, don't worry about it.
Okay, executive decision.
Yeah.